is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
How many times we get to celebrate SMOC, that is St. Mary's College, so they come out not only in rugby but also in football. They have a SMOC league, which is for the OBs for different years, 2000, 2001, 2002. But tell you what, it's 2020 and the league will be getting underway. We have covered a few moments of the SMOC league, and tell you what, it is emotions put in check, but also the fact that it's more of a network of OBs coming out to play the game of football. And 2020 might not be any different from 2019. I've had the privilege to see a few, you know, the big boys, including the Nemo Stars player in Georgia Poru, who's the OB of SMAC. And tell you what, these guys come out, I think every once in a month, twice in a month, down in at Legends to, yeah, not only just to, you know, to network, but also showcase what used to be of them back in their school days. But Cyclone on 27 points, and of course the team right there with that's ALCS, I'm told, is on 32 points. You want to think that it's a league that needs to be recognized, but at the same time still looking for more, you know, funding in terms of publicity, and better yet still, the fans still come at lunchtime in large numbers.
I think most of the traditional schools have done a decent job, you know, in terms Ontario of creating.
Well,
Ontario have got a league, you know, Namiliango have got their own league. Those that went to Muri have their own league as well. So most of the traditional schools have kept the culture of, you know, a networking, of reminiscing, of all the alumni coming together quite strong. And I think I've got handy to St. Mary's College Kisubi, because what they did is that they decided to come up to 18 different teams, and they decided to come up with a league of their own. So every once in a while they come together and get to play fixtures. And if you look at the team that is at the top of the summit, which is Alks, they've collected Alks. 32 points, 5 points ahead of the Cyclones, who are second. And by the look of things, it's between these two sides that are battling it out. But for me, I think beyond the football and the sports that they get to play, it's about getting to share contact. It's about getting to network as well. It's about getting to build your network and getting to meet different people in different professions. Because at the end of the day, when you guys get out of school, everyone embarks on a different journey. So when you have sports, it's something that transcends which kind of job you're doing. So it's an opportunity for everyone to come together. And interestingly, some of the corporate companies have actually come on board, because I've seen a couple of hospitality facilities that are actually on there. Mm-hmm. You know, you could speak of entertainment hubs as well that are part of the league. I think they've got about 8 different sponsors that are on board there. So it's quite something good. And I think for me, this should be a learning opportunity for all the different schools, or all the different universities as well, because we have so much of the secondary schools and probably the universities, but there's little of the primary schools. I think we should pretty much go down a little bit below and also think of the primary schools as well. But that being said, fantastic for SMAC, and I'll have to wait and see. Will it be the Cyclones? Will it be the Arcs? I think the Arcs have a bit of an edge now.
Well, they do take branding quite seriously. I mean, you look at the teams, you know, the outfits, they're much nicer compared to UPL. But that being said, Moses Tumusibe comes out to speak to us after the start of the 2020 SMOC League down at Legends.
My name is Tumusibe Moses, the president of the SMOC League. The SMOC League is a social networking initiative for the old boys of St. Mary's College Kisubi with our friends and family, which is packaged in form of a soccer league, as you can see right here. This league is in its fourth season as we speak today. This is season 4. We have been running for 3 years, and the reasons behind the formation, or why we have this league, is really to network, socialize, be there for each other, and stay fit. The winner of this league walks away with a very good trophy, courtesy of SoccerNet. SoccerNet is a sports store, we are our sponsors, and we don't attach prize money, but the biggest thing here are bragging rights, because these teams you see here have history that is more than actually from 20 years ago. So the bragging rights is really why we play and coming together.
Well, Fat 10 Bombers will have been selected ahead of the qualifiers. And I tell you what, one thing will stand out. Boxing will rise again and will deliver as far as it's concerned. Down the years, it has come out at this very stage. It has not disappointed. And I do believe come 2020, it will not disappoint like it has been the case in the last 5 or 6 years or so. Boxing is one of the top sporting disciplines we have in the country in terms of delivery. And 13 Bombers have been selected for the qualifiers. I want to believe that the usual names might just show up, but even then, the unknowns as well will have an opportunity for themselves to come out and showcase and do the country proud.
It was quite the successful weekend for the trials that happened down in Lugogo. And initially, there was a pool of about 180 boxers that had enrolled across the different classes, right from the featherweight, the lightweight, the welterweight, the middleweight, the heavyweight, interesting, the super heavyweight as well. And you look at these particular qualifiers, and you know, according to UBF, they had to trim down the number to just 26. And it's from that 26 that they finally came up with a shortlist of the final 13. Now, these 13 are going to be heading down to Dakar, that is in Senegal, for the continental qualifiers ahead of the Olympics that should be happening later this particular year in Tokyo, in Japan. First of all, kudos to UBF for putting together the trials over the weekend quite successfully. The fans came out in big numbers to support, even when there was a small fee to be paid, 5,000 and 10,000, because UBF came out and said, listen, we do not have the resources financially, so we are going to make some of the fans actually pay. And for me, the attitude from the fans was something quite impressive. So was the boxing in the ring, because some of the usual names didn't get to survive. For the women, Helen Baleke, who was you know, a medalist at the All Africa Games, couldn't make the cut for the women. And she's not one of the five ladies that will be representing the country, but there's a couple of other interesting ladies that came through the ranks. For the men's, I don't think there were that many surprises. Probably besides Joshua Tukamuheva from the flyweight, everyone else made the cut. You could speak of the national bombers captain, who is Shadil Musa. He came through his matches quite easily. You could speak of the two medalists from the All Africa Games, that is David, you know, Semujo and Isaac Masembe as well, who also had quite the interesting run. So I think it's quite the strong team that we are putting out there. And we all know the hope will be that they get to perform quite well at the continental qualifiers. And the hope is that we get to have medals and success coming through at the Olympic Games, because over the years, we all know that if it's not been athletics, it's always been the boxing. So we want to wish Team Uganda the best of luck as they head down to Dakar, Senegal. And the hope is that they have all the facilitation in terms of the gear, in terms of the allowances, in terms of the accommodation, in terms of the food as well, for them to actually be able to go out there and represent the country strong.
You've got to feel for some of the standout names from the All African Games. Of course, you mentioned Helen Abadeke in there, but that one young man, Joshua Tukamuheba, quite the outstanding champ he was during the schools or open boxing championship, and also during the All Africa Games, the first of its kind for him, one from Fort Porto. But even then, in a way, his dreams have been cut short for 2020 as far as playing or fighting in the Olympics gets to go. For such youngsters like him, where does that leave him in terms of aspirations?
I think it's a bit of a knockback, because truth be told, he's a relatively young man. But then also, he knows that over the next coming couple of months or even years, he's going to have so many opportunities to actually prove himself. So for now, it's about continuously getting back to the drawing board, taking part in as many competitions as possible, because boxing is a sport that needs a lot of patience, needs a lot of discipline. I think Joshua has got that, because he fostered him here so many different times. And, you know, given that there is a limited number of slots to qualify for the continental qualifiers, only 13 boxers could make the cut, but there's a lot of talent that came out on show and on display over the weekend down in Lugogo. So so many of these kids have a bright future ahead of them. All they need to do is keep their heads up, continuously keep working towards improving their game, certainly sharpen up their skills. And I think for me, staying within the right circles, having the right people around them, because boxing has constantly always been linked with the violence, with a lot of, you know, so much crime. So if these kids can stay in the right circles and stay focused on what they want to do, then I think for me, it's not just about playing at the Olympics, but you could get into the Commonwealth Games. You know, you could get to go pro someday, like we've seen Shafiq, Shafiq Chuanuka going. So there's so many different ways through which they can get to improve their careers.
Let's briefly look at the 13 names that met the final squad going to Dakar in Senegal for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic qualifiers. And of course, one of them being Desan Mobiru, Isaac Masembe, featherweight fighter, Yassin Adinan, a lightweight, Shadi Musa, Walter Waite, David Semuju, who we shall be hearing from in a few moments from now. He's a middleweight fighter. Joshua Made, light heavyweight fighter. And of course, Alex Bambare, heavyweight in there. The only heavyweight, actually, that met the card. Solomon Kimono Gekko, a super heavyweight. And of course, down the list, we do have for the women, that is in Catherine Nanziri, who's a flyweight, Susan Akello, featherweight. And of course, Rebecca Amongin, a lightweight. And finally in there, the last two, Emily, that is Nakalema and Doreen Nassari, welter and middleweight fighters, respectively. Those are the 13 bombers going out to Senegal for the Olympic qualifiers. And hopefully for them, they'll make the final card, if possibly all 13 coming out. And the more numbers, the more medals expected to be gotten. Let's hear from David Semuju after he made the final card heading to Senegal. That, of course, as of now. But quickly, elsewhere, we talk about the possible move of one Joel Madondo, set to move for a big one in North Africa, that is in Morocco, where he'll be expected to sign for a club. We have two right backs already on the move in regards to their new club sides. One rejoining a club where he used to play, that is in Agra, Chiria, with Bright Stars now joining as a free agent. The other being, of course, youngster as well, Atendire, coming out to join Wakiso Giants for Onduparaka. He was at Masaka SS and then up until then joining Onduparaka and then leaving Onduparaka to join the side in Wakiso Giants. The big one there is Joel Madondo. He's actually set to sign for the side in the side for Morocco. We've seen Morocco is not a very good hunting ground in terms of success for many Ugandans. Mohamed Shaban went there, didn't really get much in terms of success. This season alone looks like Joel Madondo's efforts might just pay off from all the way from Abusogaland.
Joel Madondo from last season was in the running for the top scorer's gong alongside Juma Balinya. Unfortunately, Juma Balinya managing to leapfrog him in there. And after the end of the campaign, he had trials in Turkey. It looks like things didn't work out in Turkey, so he actually had to come back home ahead of the second round or the second season. And I think for me, he's been fantastic still. He's continuously kept his head down, kept putting in the work for, you know, Busoga United, and now the big opportunity has come. There's reports suggesting that he could be heading down to Wydad Casablanca. For those that know about North African football, Wydad Casablanca is one of the biggest clubs there is. They are former CAF Champions League winners, and they've got the pedigree. So you think that would be actually a step up for him in terms of his career. Just like you mentioned, North Africa has not been the easiest place in the recent past. We've seen reports coming through and suggesting that Patrick Kadu could be under a lot of pressure at RS Bakena in Morocco because his performances have not been that impressive for the club. Most recently, we saw that is Mourosho Djoukou as well moving down to Morocco. Unfortunately, things have been up and down for him. He's yet to assert himself into the team. And we also got to see Shaban Mohamed playing in Morocco as well. Things didn't work out, so he had to come back home. So it's always been a mixed campaign for most of our players. But the paycheck is always bigger, but the challenges also come in handy because for most of these North African countries and most of their clubs, they tend to look at results first. So once you are not delivering on the field of play, once you are not executing, it becomes quite hard for the players. And to be said, it's also hard to break into the first team because you've got all these natives and guys that come from North Africa. So to unseat them in the team is also something quite hard. So we do want to hope that Joel Madondo can be able to go out there, thrive, because as a forward or as a striker, your primary target is always to score goals. That is, in essence, the reason as why you get to move to a club. So he'll be required to score the goals there. But on the local scene, Jarige Atelende is one of the most promising talents that came through the ranks at, Onduparaka. And you have a sense that that will be a very big move for him. And clearly the window so far has been quite interesting because we spoke about Paul Mutrezi moving to Vipers. We've seen Vitalis Tabu joining Bull as well. So many of the clubs are looking to reinforce in so many different ways. So the hope is that by the time the window can actually come to a close, then most of these teams have actually gotten into shape. They've got the right squads to be able to work with. But I think for me, for most of the players now, they're also looking for opportunities to grow in their careers as well.
Well, tell you what, the deals that are yet to be sealed, we do have one for Juma Balinya. He formerly played for Police FC, scoring, 19 goals last season. And I tell you what, he is, or he might be on his way to the side in Chetuma FC, being coached by Mia Mia, that is an ex-KCCA legend in Jackson Mayanja. We talk about, of course, Hakim Sechito, who won the Uganda Cup title last season with a Pro Line, beating up on Bright Stars in the finals. He might be, or rather, he is already on his way to Kansai Blascombe, where he has put pen to paper with the lower division clubs. Still to come, Ayub Khalifa and company, having had a successful residential training session ahead of the under-17 Women's World Cup qualifiers against a side, but beat them not too far, not too long ago. That's in Ethiopia. We talk about vengeance time in leg one of the under 17 Women's World Cup qualifiers 2020 in Qatar. And I tell you what, this story will continue. Uganda Premier League football will be returning with match day 17. The tax collectors who have been relocated to Luweero will be up against the Jogos.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.